Stephen has it all. As a person, he's a fantastic person. As a philanthropist, he's done a lot. He's helped a lot of people during his playing days. And as a leader, he has all the top qualities of leadership. As a footballer, top. I don't need to tell you. You could see, or you all know the clubs that Stephen played for, from where he started and where he ended up to. I mean, he had it all. He was one person that, I mean, we all felt like brothers in camp. It doesn't matter whether you're a junior player or you're a domestic professional or a foreign professional. We all felt equally in camp. The way he would talk to you, the way he would address you, and the way he would even involve you in decision making. Stephen always involves the playing body in decision making, so he makes you feel that you are part of decision makers, and therefore you are important to the group. And that is how he was able to achieve his aim and his goal. You could see during his days, I mean, he qualified us to the maiden World Cup of Ghana in Germany 2006. I had the opportunity to be with him in the Olympic Games as well. And, I mean, I offered him the captaincy. He rejected it. Wow. He said, "My boy, just have a feel of the captainship so that you know how leadership is." He, like a form of grooming me, you understand? So, Stephen is a top-notch person. When it comes to achievements and then not individual achievement of the national team and personality, not to talk about sporting side. When you talk about sporting side, we only have one maestro. That is Abedi Pele. Best footballer, Abedi Pele. But when we talk about the best captain so far for the national team, Stephen Appiah. I mean, nobody comes close. Talking about achievements, well, he qualified us to the World Cup. Yes, and I mean, we had less issues during his days in camp. There wasn't any captaincy issue. There wasn't any tribal issue or anything. I mean, we were so united to the extent that. So the most successful captain of the Black Stars, no doubt, is Stephen Appiah.